Hey, what's good? This is St. Joe, soundsofgear.com, here with the XT power bank. I did a video showing how to use the ripcord and a USB battery with the MPC-1, but in my comments, I think it was Tree Signs, somebody told me about this battery bank, so I wanted to check it out, and I'm going to let you know how it works with the MPC-1, as well as the MPC-X and the Akai Force. So let's check it out. All right, so here's the XT power bank. You can see, man, it's not that much bigger than a normal USB power bank. You can see the specs right there as far as the model number, all the outputs and everything like that. But if you go to the actual product page, this can put out up to 4 amps, which can handle the MPC just fine, which is dope. And then let me show you the, like the outputs and stuff. So you can see all the ports right there. I mainly use this one with the cable that comes with it, because it plugs directly into the back of the MPC. They also come with some that have like little adapter attachments for different types. I think they had one that I used that fit the Machine Plus, for example. So it comes with a few different, I guess you call them barrel heads or whatever, right there. But the one that it just comes with by default works fine with the MPC. Then on the front, when you press it, it lights up. I know you probably can barely see that, but so you can see now it's blinking when you hold it. And you can go through the volts. So whatever you need, 15, 20, 24, 16. Obviously I'm leaving on 19 volts for the MPC, and then how much time or capacity you got left. So, all right, you can see it right there. I'm about to start it up on the Force. Start up the Force. See, it shows you the wattage when it starts up. See how many watts it's pulling right now. And now it's on. So we're good. And let me just show you that the Force is playing. As you can see, the Force is on. I can, you know, go through, do whatever I need to do, load my stuff, no problems. And it just works. You know what I'm saying? So go to my projects. Stuff loads up just fine. Everything's lit up. I mean, probably can't really tell. It's probably bright on you, but yeah. So yeah, works with the Force, no problem. Handles it the same way it handles the MPC-1. Also, I'm going to show you that it powers up the MPC-X as well. All right, so you can see I got it plugged into the X. See the X starting up. You can see the wattage. And we're on, so I can go in, you know, go into my browser. I'm just showing you, I'm just focusing mainly on this, but you can see in the background that we're good to go. So I can go into my projects and just load up something. Just make sure we're good. Go back to the main screen, press play. And you see we're playing, we're good. So you can see all stuff going, and you see right here. So yeah, it definitely works. It runs this joint with no problem. Haven't had any problems. I mean, I don't run the X on a battery or even the Force for that matter, but I wanted to check since they have the same kind of requirements as far as power and amps and stuff like that. So just wanted to show you that, hey, this joint does indeed handle it. So all right, so I got it plugged into the MPC. All right, I got the MPC plugged into it. Start it up. Shows you the wattage that it's pulling. And you can see the MPC starting up just fine. You can see the wattage. But once it's done starting up, you're good to go. You can see I'm in there. Good to go. Let's just do empty project. And yeah, now I can go in and do, you know, whatever I would normally do. I can browse, go into, and it's still, you know, you're still going to get the readout because it's pulling the power. So everything that's going on in there, you're going to get. So let's see. Now just load something up real quick. So yeah, I mean, you see it, it's playing. You can see the wattage. So yeah, this will work with the MPC-1, also works with the Force and the X. They all, like I said, they all have the same 19 volt 3.4 amp requirement. So it runs with all of them. I don't use it with the X or the Force, to be honest. I mainly use it with the 1 when I'm not in the lab or when I'm away from the desk, mainly when I'm sitting on the couch and stuff like that. But I did measure how long this lasts, and I just left it running on the 1 just like for a whole day or, you know, half a day or whatever. I got up to like 7.5 hours and still had a little bit of battery time left. So definitely very capable of running this joint and probably other, you know, other stuff. But for me, I was mainly looking at it for this, and for, I think the price was like $89. I think it's worth it, to be honest, to give you a little bit more portability. It's not super big, you know what I'm saying? So it's not really an issue. I can stick it to the bottom of it if I want, or I can just, you know, take it with me, whatever I want to do. But yeah, let me know what you think. Like, comment, subscribe to the channel if you dig it. Also, if you're looking for plugins, presets, sample packs, tutorial courses, all that stuff, stop by the Sounds and Gear shop. It definitely helps out the site, helps out the channel. Till next time, I'll see y'all later. Peace.